Christiana from Nafkamin, lovely to meet you.
Yeah, so,
congratulations for this award. And for those unfamiliar with White Riot, what is the story about and why did you want to tell it?
So the story is about the Rock Against Racism Carnival that happened in 1978, which was led by The Clash. But it's really about the guys behind the carnival and about what they went through to put this on, where 100,000 young people marched from Trafalgar Square to Victoria Park to stand up against the far right.
Why did you want to tell this story in particular?
So when I started out on this journey to tell the story, I was just blown away that the story hadn't been told. You know, and all my stories, all my films that I've made previously, are really about the about youth culture and about music and, you know, the power of arts really to change people's lives. So when I came across the story of Rock Against Racism, I felt that this was something that, you know, really spoke to me, and I'm, you know, just passionate about those kind of stories.
What do you hope is going to be the impact on the audience?
I hope that the audience are going to learn something new. I hope that they're going to take something away from it, and that they're going to be able to have a look at what happened in the late 70s and maybe think about how some of those themes and some of those events are happening now.
What was the biggest challenge in the production of the documentary?
Oh, wow, that's a big question. So in terms of the biggest challenge, was actually making the film. I mean, it was a big feat. The story actually takes place over 5 or 6 years, and we had to really hone down on what it is that we were interested in and what was the story that we wanted to tell. So I think our story really focuses on the birth of Rock Against Racism, which is the first kind of 18 months, which is an incredible story and one that I'm really excited for audiences to see.
What do you think is important that White Riot was here presenting at the London Film Festival?
I think it's important on so many levels. I think it's timely. I think it's like a quintessentially British story, and I think it's, you know, it's got massive London components. So I think it's very topical, and I think the audience has really responded to it because they were here. You know, there were a lot of people that actually were at the carnival. There were people that travelled from all over the UK to come and watch the film.
Can you tell us what's next for you?
So a couple more documentaries, more documentaries definitely. I have an idea for a kind of spin-off for this film, which is completely different, but kind of is born out of the story of Rock Against Racism, that I'm hoping will be my next film.
Was started by a group of artists that really made this project from nothing. But it's really about the story of youth culture and about how the youth in that time stood up against the National Front of the Far Right. So all of my films kind of involve youth culture and really about, I try to find quite inspirational stories. And so this story, when I found it, I was amazed that nobody had told it. And so that was actually 5 years ago. And I was, you know, I was like kind of passionate about wanting to tell this story, but I didn't realise that the events of the next 5 years, which is the previous 5 years from now, were about to happen. So, you know, Trump, Brexit, all sorts of different things that, as you probably know. So it just became more and more timely as we proceeded to make the story. Wow, that's a big question. As I said, when we started this journey to tell this story about Rock Against Racism, we really, really didn't know that the events of the future were about to happen. But somewhere in our minds must have been kind of in the zeitgeist of that kind of far-right sentiment. So I think that was kind of the
So it's a crime story, but really it's about investigating her.
It's always about the real people behind these big movements, the real people behind the film that tell these stories, that really make them matter to lots of people.
People think of noir as like Humphrey Bogart in a raincoat and sort of doing an impersonation. But in today's cinema, that would just be a pastiche. This character is a young woman who's very tough, but at the same time very vulnerable and very complicated. I knew that Alicia would be able to render her in all her